was born there. It was actually Italy. So I said, Lino, tell people you're from Italy. So you all have met him before, I'm sure. Here he is. Lino, see, there's your picture up there.
Yes.
And we have your PowerPoint started. And here's Gannat.
Oh, nice to see you.
All right.
Hello, Lino, and welcome.
Yeah.
Get going which way?
Okay. Longevity.
This is Lino Stanchich, and I will teach about dynamic longevity.
Okay.
Actually, aging is great. You'd be surprised, the older I get, the happier I get. First of all, to be alive. And the second thing is also, there's different kind of life. You notice things that you noticed before. So slow down and
come up a little bit.
Anyway, I enjoy more life.
Can you all hear Lino?
Yeah.
Can you hear him okay?
Okay. I don't know. Can they hear me okay?
Okay. Gannat says yes. All right, go ahead.
Aging is great. It means you have lived a longer life. So congratulations. It sure beats the alternative. So I had known I would live so long, I would have taken better care of myself. That's what George Burns says when he was 100 years old. Diet and exercise is a really way to live longer. But you have to understand what kind of exercise. Keeping healthy is eat smart. That's the first thing, it's a foundation. You have to prevent diseases. Most diseases are preventable. Find more happiness in life and in what you're doing and where you're living. And I study and learn something every day. You know, so it's also a very good type of meditation, you know. Sit down on a chair, keep a good posture, and hold the book or whatever you're reading or whatever you're studying up to improve your posture and you feel better. Keep the faith. Okay. And also one thing is to help others. The more you help others, somehow it also come back to you, not necessarily from the same person. Age dynamically.
See that dot? You can speak up there. That's where they see you, right here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Common symptom of age is poor memory, dementia, and Alzheimer. Most of them are preventable to a great degree. Also fatigue. Fatigue is when you don't move enough, you know. So I love to walk, and I walk every day. Actually, I bought this house because it got a small hill on the side, and I walk up the hill and down the hill. And also there's a lake, small lake in front of me, and I like to walk around it. Okay. Also, sexual dysfunction. Well, I'm still virile and I'm over 80, so what can I tell you? But it's important if you're married or single to have some good sex, okay? Now, hearing and eyesight problems are important to improve. When I started Macrobiotic, I was wearing glasses. Believe it or not, right now I don't wear glasses anymore, you know? I heal my eyes. Now, I don't know what you know about the eyes, but the eyes are connected with many organs inside, and you enjoy life more, you know. Also, depression, you know. You'll be surprised how many people have depression, you know. If you're alive, you know, the person once was to say that he was complaining that his leg was swollen, and then he, around the corner, he found out a person without leg. So he stopped complaining anymore. you know, so now also isolation. I enjoy seeing people and being with people and sharing what I know and having some company. So have a friend to share it. Whatever you like to do, can be walking, can be swimming, can be talking, I know. Yeah. And the other is incontinence. So you can do a lot to prevent incontinence. As I said before, at my age, a lot of people get up a few times a night. I most of the time don't get up, but sometimes if I drink too much before going to bed, then I get up once, you know, and that's okay. I'm very pleased about being smart enough to have no pain and to enjoy life more. Alzheimer's in the United States. Alzheimer's is a type of dementia. Dementia is mean that the brain doesn't work too well, you know. It doesn't mean that you are crazy, but it means that you better do something about it to heal dementia. Over 6 million Americans have Alzheimer's. 6 million. Alzheimer's is not difficult to control. 1 in 9 Americans have Alzheimer's. 1 in 9, that's a lot of people, you know. And one of the healthiest things to do, what I do, is walking. The more I walk, strange enough, I feel better, you know. 44 million people worldwide have Alzheimer's. 44 million. That's ridiculous. This day and age, that's way too much. Western Europe and USA had the most cases. It's another. So we're supposed to be the one better off, the better educated, have more food, and we have more cases of Alzheimer's. You know, the financial cost in the United States is $230 billion a year. The financial cost in the United States is $230 billion. That's a lot of money. You know? So keep a healthy brain and body. The most important is oxygen. You can even go without food and without water for a few days, but without oxygen only a few minutes. So breathe, learn how to breathe. In fact, in the morning, the first thing I do, I turn on my back and bend my knees, and I start breathing in there. In a few minutes, I feel more awake, and I get up, and life is better. So also when I walk, I learn how to breathe walk, you know, which I'm not going to teach now, but I'll be very happy in the future to teach. I teach breathing, walking, breathing, eating, and also breathing, loving, you know, and that is also very helpful and more pleasurable, you know. Also, the food that you eat. You know. Diet is very important, not only to keep alive, you know, it's to keep more alive. Macrobiotic is definitely as the diet for longevity, you know. Vegetarian people or semi-vegetarian, especially macrobiotic, is a very smart way to live longer, you know. Basic for brain health. Diet is the base, plant-based diet. Lifestyle relationship and sleep. Sleeping is exercise important, but also sleep. When you go to sleep, early to sleep, early to get up, is one of the healthiest thing habits you can have. You know. Exercise, move. often when I get up in the morning, I go, you know, after there, I dance without music, with nothing. I dance by myself, especially when Jane is busy leaving the toilet or sleeping longer. And I enjoy dancing. You know? And that is all. You can also put music if you feel like it, you know. And also to create a healthy environment, something that you really, not that you enjoy, but is also healthy, you know. All medicine has side effects. Now, if you need medicine, please take it, you know. But do things, do anything possible to that you don't need it, you know. The organ in the body that affects the whole body is, in my opinion, hormones and thyroids. So hormones, male and female, and thyroid also affect the weight and the thinking. The thyroid affects practically everything, you know. And add so much, if needed, add nutritional supplement. Make sure that the food you eat nourish you, not only taste good or look good, but actually make you more sane. Dementia is a chronic and progressive syndrome, you know. So if you don't do something, you're going to become a little more mental problem, especially when you aging, you know. It affects the memory, thinking, behavior, and ability to perform things. Also, if you use the hammer and a nail, you're going to hit much more often your finger in a process. Worldwide, over 50 million people live with dementia. Worldwide, over 50 million people live with dementia. I don't know, when the government that you live in, our country, you should do something about, regardless what you're doing, which country you live, you know. This number are accepted to triple by 2050, you know. Let's do to prevent it. Read about it, or talk about it, or try to control dementia, prevent it. Okay. These numbers are expected to triple by the year 2050. Dementia cost the United States of America $604 billion in 2010. Also, what it does, if you don't drink enough liquids, or your diet doesn't have to be, I'm talking about only water, I'm talking about soups and so on, the brain, Alzheimer is actually the brain shrink, it dry up, it gets smaller, and it doesn't function well. So make sure that you have more liquids, and by try to chew it, learn how to chew it, not to only swallow, gargle it down, you know. Give a cup of chew, think there's solid food, you know. First of all, you find out you're going to urinate less, but everything is going to function better, you know. Vegetable, eat more vegetable, and also fruits, but especially vegetable. And if you live in a place in the country where there's a more dry, like in Arizona and so on, then drink more water. But if you drink in the north, where there's plenty of water, then drink less, you know? Okay, control your urination. What are amyloid plaques, you know? In biochemistry, is a way translucent substance composed primarily of protein, fiber that is deposited in various organs in animal in certain diseases.
Okay.
Dietary causes of dementia. Saturated fat and sucrose. Sucrose means sugar. Sugar in any shape or form, you know. I mean, you don't have to completely eliminate it, but white sugar, yes. White sugar is a drug. It's not actually there. Eat fruits, eat dry fruits, you know, cooked fruits, fresh fruits, but avoid white sugar. And not only avoid white sugar, but anything that contains it or anything is made with it, you know. Also environmental toxins, you know. We are surrounded by right now, to preserve things and so on. We don't want too many toxins. Whatever is necessary is fine, but not too much, you know. And pesticides, buy organic food and organic fruits. First of all, they taste better, you know. Second thing, they're better for you. So, National Institutes of Health Report. Study indicated that diet with high contents of trans and saturated fats adversely affect cognition, basic cognition, thinking. Now, too much fat is not. Use it, of course. Prefer solid fats are not healthy. Prefer more oils, you know. I like more olive oil, but you can use any kind of oils that is healthy and so on. We actually eating smart is smart. The same diet that prevents high blood pressure and cholesterol blockage is also prevent arthritis, allergy, and cancer. You know? Also prevent Alzheimer and dementia. Now they find out that the blue zones, then Butner, the world's longest people are in Okinawa. It's an island off the coast of Japan. It's part of Japan, but is in the island. They are people who live the longest. And find out that those people are more friendly. They visit each other, they have dinner together and so on. So don't be close. If you live and you have a neighbor, visit them, invite them for dinner, then hopefully they're going to invite us. So if they are more family, then once a week or whatever you want, get together with the people, you know. Eat a plant-based diet. You know, not a high protein or high fat, a plant-based, you know. Loma Linda and the Seventh-day Adventists are known of United States, but actually around the world, for people who live longer and are happier, you know. Mediterranean regions are the same thing. You know, if you go in the south of Italy, people they invite each other for dinner. They spend outside. They go in the beach. They hike more and so on. So don't stay home all the time. Make a point to go every day out to a certain region. Genius diet. The genius diet are people who want to think better. Renowned world geniuses are vegan. So Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, Leonardo da Vinci, Thomas Jefferson, Ben Franklin, Einstein, probably many more that we don't know about it, you become more smarter, more brainy, you know. And this by reading, by listening to program, not only something for entertainment, you know? Also to become more smart, you know. Doctor who promote a healthy plants-based diet, especially like me, Bernard, powerful for the brain. You know, I happened to meet him. He was actually teaching in the cruise for several years. And he also wrote a book, Power Foods for the Brain. So that's a very good book that I recommend it highly. And Colin Campbell's PhD, he wrote a book, The China Study, and he has some problem because of it. But he also, China Study is a very good, introduce you to a different way of life and thinking, you know, and living. Sherry Roger, MD, I met her several times, puts her patient on a plant-based organic diet. Basically, she also studied macrobiotic with Mitchell Cushy. I remember I was in Boston at the time too. It was a vegan macrobiotic, you know. Diet to heal mainly is more vegetable and more healing. Environmental, because that environmental illnesses are caused mostly by the food that you eat and what you drink, as well as how you sleep and how you move. Dean Ornish, MD, we also teach many years ago in Miami Beach. Recommend a plant-based diet with plenty of fruit and vegetables, grain, legumes, beans, and supplementation. Strange enough, we were going to the same lectures, mostly it was by Mitchell Cushy and people who are really into food. And he also believed in preventive medicine. And he also had a research institute in California. The father of medicine says, let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food. This is Hippocrates, 450 years before Christ. 450 years before Christ, he was saying, food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food. Nothing will benefit the human health and increase chance for survival on life on earth as much as the evolution to a vegetarian diet. This is Albert Einstein, supposedly one of the best brain in the Western world, you know? So join the top genius around, you know? Okay. The same diet that lower blood pressure, reduce cholesterol, prevent heart disease, and so prevents dementia and Alzheimer's. So try to think about it and do your best to become smarter. The best way to nourish the brain is whole grain. Brown rice go on the top, but also quinoa for Western people. For some people, it's better, you know. Oats, millet, amaranth, wheat, but depends what kind of, make sure it's organic wheat. Spelt is a type of wheat. Barley, corn grits. These are the whole grain. Every civilization on earth have one or more of this, you know. The other one, wheat grain, is the beans, legumes, and bean products. Chickpeas is on top. It's good for the brain, but it's also good for the heart. So chickpeas is also, hummus is very good. My wife is crazy about hummus, you know what I mean? I like it too, you know? Lentils, azuki beans, they call them also azuki beans, pinto beans, black beans, turtle beans, kidney beans, tempeh and tofu. All of these beans are good for certain organ. Find out which one is connected with which organ. If not, call my wife, you know, in depth there. And you're going to become smarter, you know? And also you're going to become healthier. Plant protein or animal food. Content of protein grain in 100 grain.
This is the content.
Oh. Beef have 13.7
grams.
Equal.
Mm-hmm. Grams. Okay. Just compare, you can compare.
Chicken have 18.6. Cheese have 24.9. Kidney beans at 23.6. So you got more protein than beans. You know? Brown rice has 7.5. Barley has 12.5. Almond have 23. So you don't have to eat a high protein diet, which is hard on the body, but also eat also other things like brown rice, kidney beans, and so on. Plain protein.
Okay, let's move on. They get the point. Okay.
Okay, vegetable. Vegetables are alkalizing. If you eat, especially when if you eat a food that have more fat, and eat vegetable with it. You know, vegetable are antioxidant.
That's
fine. Students, pinto, plant nutrients, provide moisture to the body, vitamin, minerals, fiber, color, so they look better and also they're delicious. Greens, sweet ground, and roots, that's the best. Special vegetable for aging. I'm interested in that because I'm the one who gets. Incidentally, not many people go over 80. Now I don't take any medication whatsoever, zero. You know, I eat some special foods. But the vegetable help break down fat in the cells. Blood reduce cholesterol. And help relieve congestion, plaque, and blockages. Shiitake mushroom is great. First of all, if you want to lose weight, but not only that, it melts fats, especially in the brain, and other part of the world, you know. So shiitake mushroom is I suggest to eat often, you know. The best one comes from Japan, but in America right now they cultivating also some very good one, you know. Also daikon radish cuts fats, you know. So start eating some daikon radish there. In Germany, strange enough, they eat a lot. I found out that the Germans eat a lot of daikon. Wow. You know. Fruits increase learning ability. University of Cincinnati study found that drinking grape juice or blueberry juice lead to a major
gain
in learning and short-term memories. Now, add organic grapes to salads. You know. Toss organic berry into cereal and smoothies. Give fruits to kids as a snacks rather than, you know, stuff with sugar. And you eat them too. Nuts and seeds. That's a vegetable protein. Make sure you have it every day, if not every meal. Depend on there. Too much beans, you can gain weight. But if you pick up the right one, it won't. Nuts and seeds. Those ones are better than beans, in my opinion. But try them all and see which one you feel attracted to it, you know, or tastes better for you, you know. Maybe 1 year you won't like it, the next 1 year you will, because your body will tell you what you need. Listen to your body. Listen to your craving. Also, listen to what your conscience tell you, you know.
You're not talking.
Lino, can you tell me why you think nuts and seeds are better than beans?
Okay, so nuts and seeds, the beans are more or less have more fat, and also you have to use salt to make them more palatable, you know. Now, seeds are different. Seeds you can roasted. I like pumpkin seeds without anything, you know. And so in other words, the beans need salt. And most people in the world, including the United States, eat salt. And I can make a whole lecture about salt, because salt are very important. That's where we get in most of our minerals, you know.
But Lino, do you also feel people should have beans every day?
Yeah.
He believes in beans too.
Also, listen, men need a little more beans, you know, and I'm a male, so I like some beans every day. You women can eat either less or less often, you know, because definitely bean, you gain weight, you know. But I'm a fast metabolizer, so I can eat beans twice a day, you know. But women usually, for some reason, gain more weight if they eat beans, too much beans, you know. So also depend on how you chew. Bean, if you chew it, give you plenty of energy. If you don't chew it, it gives you gas, which is, beside that, it is noisy. Also, it smells. It is not very, very sociable, accepted, you know what I mean?
So one thing we do take enzymes for, digestive enzymes will knock out any flatulence.
Yes, so you heard what the Jane said.
Repeat it, honey. It's important.
With beans, you need some digestive enzymes, you know. This can be something like seeds, some kind of fats that help you digest it, and also mineral, especially the best mineral to digest beans is seaweed. See, there are different kinds of seaweed. You can try the one you feel attracted the most, but seaweed is the best source of some minerals that you don't find in any other place, you know? Go ahead. Healthy sweeteners, okay. Now here we, most people like sweets, not only children, but many men and women, you know. And a little sweets is fine, you know, but too much sweets or the wrong kind of sweets, it's not fine at all, you know. Too much sweets make you stupid, you know. The brain, the sweets in food or in fruits or in as a syrup and so on, go up to the brain, you know. So fine, you can, it's nice to have desserts and so on, but too many desserts is no. Some people eat two desserts after a meal, you know. Well, I don't think so, that's too smart, you know what I mean? Definitely not going to make you smarter, you know what I mean? So find out why you need it, because usually people who eat too much salt also want sweets, or they want alcohol, or things of salt. So you can find out how you can control it so you don't have to have difficulty, you know. I like sweet drinks, you know. It's a type of sugar that is sweet.
Brown rice syrup. Brown rice syrup. Tell them what it is, honey. What is it? Okay.
So it's also the sweet vegetable, you know. Maple syrup, the barley malt, there is a there's also fruits, there's a, you know.
Stevia
is also very good. It's a vegetable sweetener, you know.
You can actually grow it.
You can grow it at home, even if you live in an apartment, you know. So stevia is definitely, for to me, one of the best way to get sweets in your body and in your life. Spices make food taste better, but it's also for aging, to slow down aging. Spices are also good because it affects the brain, and the brain function better, not too much, but definitely on a daily basis, like turmeric and curcumin and rice-fed curcumin develop fewer animal plaque associated with Alzheimer's, so you can prevent and also make your food taste better. Curry or several spices also good. Sage and rosemary improve memory. Sage and rosemary, garlic, thin blood and lower cholesterol, you know. Then there is also wasabi helps nerve cells grow, tries for synapse improvement. Ginger root slices in stir fry and also in tea, you know. India has notable less Alzheimer than any other country in the world. So, and they use a lot of
turmeric,
you know.
They're also mostly vegetarian.
And they're also mostly vegetarian, you know what I mean? So, nourish your brain. Nourish your emotions, more and healthier food. This is my specialty. I make pickles. In my house, we always have pickles, and it's very easy to make it. And you get it in 5 days. Of course, there's also things like sauerkraut. You can make it once a year, you know. Miso. Miso is a very good condiment. I think there are many kind of miso, you know. I like them as sprays on crackers, you know. Tamari, shoyu sauce, and so, you know, and shoyu. That's also a good a condiment, you know. Vinegars. Having a salad without some kind of a vinegar, something sour, it makes the taste of the vegetable much better. And there's a thing called natto. Well, that depends, it's a question of taste, you know what I mean? But it's one of the healthiest way to increase intestinal flora and intestines. Natto, N-A-T-T-O, you know. try it a few times and start, if you like it, use it. The gut.
Oops, sorry.
The gut-brain connection. It also helps produce B12 and also affect the brain and the thinking and ideas. With natural probiotic minerals. Food to avoid. Refined sugar. Anything I see that have white sugar in it, I never even tasted. Okay. Now dairy product is fermented in a certain amount is okay, but too much it is not okay at all. You know, also meat. I don't eat meat at all. I find out I think better, I feel better, and I'm happier. So whatever it is, I don't eat meat. Eggs, if you're going to eat eggs in baking and so on, occasionally a small amount is okay. But too much eggs make you...
You don't believe in eating bacon.
Excuse me?
Bacon, you don't believe people should eat bacon or eggs, either one, right?
Okay.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you, Lena? Do you believe they should have bacon? No.
No, we don't eat bacon.
No.
Refined flour, especially hard dry crackers, processed food. Avoid and chemicalized foods, GMO, non-organic foods. Don't use it. You know, trans fats, hydrogenated fats. Those ones don't digest. Yeah, make it the food taste better, but definitely it's not good for the body and it's not good for the brain. You know, actually it's not good for the reproductive organ either, you know, at least not in mine. But so eat for feeling better, thinking better, behaving better, and also be happier and healthier.
Okay, check your medications. We've already gone over that.
Exercise for dynamic aging. This is mainly for people who are getting older or don't want to get older. And that is outdoor exercises. In other words, moving and breathing. You can do exercises, you can play with balls, you can do all kinds of stuff. And if you're a woman, especially men also, gardening, you know. Walking is my best way. I like to walk. Actually, I teach breed walking, and I teach many different styles of walking for looking better, feeling better, and, you know, and for better posture. Bicycling, you know. If you like bicycling, that's good. But that make the legs, especially, function better. Swimming, that is the probably one of the best exercises around. You know, swimming. You know, and then is Tai Chi and Qigong. These are already you have to learn, or somebody have to teach you. You can get some from reading books, but the best thing is actually taking classes. You know? And indoor exercise, I do it every morning. You know, and yoga is very good for everybody, men and women. And I love dancing. You know, with or without mucus, with or without Jane or any other one. Yeah. And finally, the best exercise I find out. Giving the maximum benefit in a short amount of time is rebounding.
Okay. We have to move on a little bit. We don't have time to do all this, honey. So let's just let them look at it and it's mind games and then chewing well, which you talked about before.
Yeah.
Chewing well.
You are how you eat. And in fact, I wrote the book, Power Eating Program. And if you don't have it, it's inexpensive, it's small, you can read it fast, you know. And this is a how to eat. My father survived a German concentration camp, Second World War, by chewing the food. The food was the same food that everybody was eating, only they were dying. My father was not dying, you know. And when he came home, he told him how he survived. And this is the part where I was living there was part of Croatia. And I tried to escape and go to Italy, and they caught me. And I end up in a concentration camp, and I listened to everything that my father, looked at me and say, especially you, who knows why, but he told me, cultivate chewing, you know. So, and I do this every time when I sit in front of food, I calm down, I start breathing, and then I give thanks. It's very strange that we give thanks to the creator, or to the energy, infinity energy of the universe, or the, yeah. Give thanks. If you are thankful for what you have, strange enough, you get things more and easier. And cultivate good posture, especially when you get older. Try to have good posture. Good posture makes you look good, feel good, and it's better for you. And breathe, because breathing is the most important thing to do. The first thing I did in the morning, and while I'm going to the bathroom, basically, I cultivate breathing.
Okay.
And then finally, chewing well. I am known for the one who teach chewing. I even have a song about chewing, you know. So I chew as often as possible. And of course, when you're in company, you have to chew less and talk more. But in the morning for breakfast, I chew well, and the whole day go better, you know.
Okay, I think we need to close now, honey. This would be the last one, okay?
This is it.
Good night. I think we're complete now.
You are how you eat.
No, we. This is. I think we're ready to end here. We'll end with this chewing. Okay.
This has been wonderful. This is just great. Thank you, Lino. Thank you so much. Lino, thank you. Thank you so much, Lino. It's been wonderful. It's such an honor and a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much.
Okay. You are going to teach next time how to eat, okay? Take care.
Well, thank you. Do we have time for any questions?
Take care. It was nice to talk to you and to whoever listened. And again,
thanks
I wish
so
you a happy and successful life. Bye now.
Thank you.